With me now in the studio is AIM Journal's Andrew Hore. Andrew, good to see you. Good afternoon. Hello. We're talking this week Sigma Capital, Focusrite, Elecosoft and TP Group. First off, Sigma Capital, looking to raise up to £250 million through the launch of their real estate investment trust, PRS. That's a chunky number they're looking to raise. Where are they looking to spend it? And tell me a bit more about the trust.
Well, Sigma Capital itself was originally a technology investment company. It moved into regeneration, property regeneration, and it's got good links with county councils like, and city councils like Liverpool and West Midlands. And it's got lots of projects that it can move forward. The big problem with it has always been it hasn't had enough money. Now, they've launched this REIT, which will be quoted on the special funds market, and they want to raise up to £250 million, which is a lot of money, and that will enable them to go ahead with all these developments they've got, and they'll be able to grow faster. Now, whether they can get £250 million, it's hard to say yet, but the government's Home and Communities Agency is putting in £25 million, up to £25 million. So they've got a base investor there.
Right.
And they had results out yesterday. And they showed that they've already had an uplift in their property developments of £2 million. Their asset value up to 40 pence, which is around about two-thirds of the share price. They're not really necessarily something to look at in asset terms, but they're a bit of a mixture between income and growth, really. You want the income's coming through as well as the profit. They're making profits, and the asset base is going up. And this could make that this fund, these funds could make that asset base and those profits grow faster, particularly as you get a fee from the REIT to sort of manage their money for them.
Certainly could. Let's talk Focusrite. They've had results out, good interim figures.
Yes, that's right. I mean, they've done particularly well in North America. They're a company that makes specialist audio equipment, mainly for professionals who make professional music or maybe play live, and they have a sort of various levels of product, sort of down to the sort of from sort of RedNet, which is a very high professional level, which they've at the moment they've got a very small market share there because they've just launched there, but other levels, lower price, they've got sort of 20-30% market share there, so they're quite strong in sort of very much a niche market. And these results were so good that the analysts put up the profit forecast to $8.5 million. So it's, I think it was just under 10% the increase, but it was certainly very well received.
And they've got their eye on further acquisitions as well.
Yes, one of the things is they've got a new chief executive in, and he used to be quite high up at Avid Technology in the US. And he wants to sort of, I think, fill in some gaps in the product range they've got, sort of maybe widen it a bit or go into sort of other things. And because I think they've got a good reputation in the market, they can use that to sort of to expand.
Exciting times for them. Elecosoft, I know they've had a trading statement out. In particular, they've had a strong first quarter.
Yes, a very strong first quarter, up around 17%. They do benefit from exchange rates because we're still sort of comparing with pre sort of EU referendum exchange rates. So they've got that benefit in there, but they are growing as well on the back of that. There's a lot of their business, particularly is in areas like Scandinavia. And they're specialists sort of do a wide range of things for architects through to software for the construction end of the market as well. And their business seems to be booming. They're on track to sort of at least meet their forecast, with profits are increasing from 1.8 to 2.2 million this year.
It's a good performance from them. Lastly, four out of four here, Andrew. TP Group, formerly Corec.
That's right.
A specialty engineering group. Exciting times for them by the looks too. They're set to make their first profit?
Yes, this year they are set. They almost broke even last year. I mean, Corec, as some people remember, it sort of goes back nearly two decades, I think. It's certainly been on AIM for 16, 17 years, I should think. I'm pretty sure it was on OFX before that. And it was very much a development business, and they spent years, and they had some success. They sold off IP for one or two things, but never really made any money. new management came in a few years ago. They said, right, we don't want to do speculative development. We want to build up a proper, a niche engineering business. And one of the businesses they bought produces oxygen systems for submarines. So a very niche market. They the MOD, of course, is very important. They've got some sort of overseas contracts as well. And this week it was announced that their contract they had announced previously with the MOD is starting. And the first 9.7 million of it is going to come through over the next 3 years. That sort of helps to underpin this year and sort of make more confident that they're going to make that profit.
So it looks as though 2017 they could be turning a corner, finally.
Yes, and they're also trying to sort of improve the recurring nature of their revenues, because obviously there's these big contracts which are very lumpy. So they're building up a managed services business. They made one or two software acquisitions in terms of control systems for things, and so they're looking for other acquisitions. They've got cash. It was 9 million at the end of last year, but they did spend some of that more recently on their software acquisitions, but it's still net cash.
Very good. Watch the space, I reckon. Andrew, good to see you. Thanks very much.
All right, thanks.